I have to go live with this one and tell you guys that I am in Perth, Australia right now, and I just had 6 police officers escort me off of the plane because I decided to be a little bit of an activist and complain, and maybe more like raise a little hell, because they were spraying aerosol cans. So the new thing is that airplanes will now go around and spray aerosol cans throughout the cargo after the plane is landing and basically disinfect the entire airplane. They're saying that they're killing bugs, but don't worry, the bugs are not killing any people. We're just killing any bugs that could potentially come from Bali, Indonesia. So I just went a little crazy and said, this is not okay. There's children on board. You are spraying actively like toxic chemicals. You don't even know what's in the spray. And I even filmed it. And then the air stewardess basically said, would you like me to explain why you're doing this? And I said, no, I don't think this is okay. This is it's like basically we're a Nazi camp, or like you guys are just spraying through these vents and we don't even know what this stuff is. And then she said, well, I'll have immigration explain it to you instead. And so when the plane landed in Perth, 6 police officers came and got me off of the plane. Luckily, and then there was like about 5 more waiting, and luckily they were really nice, and I just explained, look, my mom died of lung cancer and I am concerned about the air supply that we have. I'm concerned about the food supply. I'm concerned about the water supply. Everything is being poisoned. Our water is poisoned, our food is poisoned, and now our air is being poisoned, and we're in a closed quarters inside of an airplane and you guys are spraying these toxic chemicals inside there and it stinks. And you could see the flight attendants, just their faces. And they said, this is standard. This is what we do in Australia. We spray and all Air Asia flights, and we have to come back with empty canisters, and if we don't, then we are gonna be in trouble. And so luckily they were nice enough, luckily I didn't get fined, and luckily I got let go, and I'm in Perth, Australia, about to board a plane from Melbourne. But it was close. And basically I said, look, I tried to be a little bit of an activist and thought that people would rally with me. I thought that they would say, yes, we don't want spraying, we don't want this, we don't want our air to be polluted, our lungs, everything, we don't want this. But guess what? None of them said that, and they all stayed very quiet like sheep. And even one man said to me, you're crazy. And I said, I'm crazy because I want clean air? Like, this is crazy. And I have to tell you that after all that happened, I just got into my heart and I just got so deeply, deeply sad that this is really the state of our world, that we are just sitting around while we're being poisoned by the food, we're being poisoned with our water, and now we're being poisoned with our air. And it's just like, not much we can do about it. And so I don't know what to say. You know, I guess from now on, if I want to fly to Australia or for anywhere, and then I just got to be okay to get sprayed. And so I got to wear my gas mask wherever I go, even when I'm in Bali, Indonesia on the scooters. Now I got to bring it inside of an airplane because you don't know what kind of toxic chemicals they're spraying. So I just wanted to let you guys know that this is the state of the world, and just to raise your awareness around, like, check out the food you're eating, read your ingredients. Like, people, please read ingredients of everything that you eat. Think about the food that you're putting inside of your body, through your mouth, through your thoughts, through the air, through everything around us. It's feeding us, and all, we're a full being, you know? And unfortunately, we just aren't being seen as a full being. We're just like, oh yeah, we're just gonna spray, we're gonna kill the bugs, and then that's not gonna what, harm any person? I mean, if a bug is gonna die, don't tell me that that's not gonna affect my lungs and hurt my body in some way, and especially that of babies that are sitting on the plane. I mean, it's just, it's friggin' tragic, absolutely tragic. And so I just wanted to raise your guys' awareness that this is happening in the world, and anything that you can do to prevent that in your own backyard, in your own homes, in your own families, read ingredients, think about the water that you drink, stop drinking plastic water, try and get spring water as much as possible, you know, read your ingredients, like, just be aware of what you put inside of your body through your food, through your water, through the thoughts that you think, and through the stuff you surround yourself with, because the government isn't looking out for us. We have to do it, and we really have to just wake up. This really is a time for massive awakening, people. Let's wake up and make sure that we are taking care of ourselves, because no one out there is taking care of us. Okay, so I am safe, I am good, and I'm on my way to Melbourne, and whew, adventure. Activism doesn't pay all the time. I'll put my focus on green smoothies instead. Okay, sending you guys so much love, and I'm in Australia, and this is my welcome. 6 or 12 officers or something escorting me off the plane. Whew. Petra's a rebel. Ciao. Love you and love all your comments. Thank you. Thank you. Bye.